Hello everyone, welcome. Finally, we have a version of the acclaimed Red Dead Redemption for the Nintendo Switch. The big question is this version the definitive one for us to play on PC without issues? Today, we will conduct rigorous tests with the game on two widely known emulators, Yuzu and Ryujinx, to determine where we will get the best results. It's worth mentioning that we can already run the game on both emulators, but it's important to note that, at this moment, the game is not fully optimized. If you're an emulator enthusiast and want to stay updated with the latest news, please don't hesitate to support this video with a like, thus contributing to reaching as many people as possible. Also, subscribe to the channel to not miss any of our upcoming videos.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
As mentioned earlier, both Yuzu and Ryujinx are capable of running the game at the time of recording this video. However, we have encountered some minor issues with both emulators. Firstly, Yuzu runs the game exclusively in OpenGL. Based on my preliminary tests, I observed satisfactory performance, reaching up to 60 FPS in native resolution at certain moments. On the other hand, Ryujinx runs the game in Vulkan but experiences issues with foliage and background objects. Despite this, its performance is commendable. It's important to note that, in general, users with AMD GPUs might face difficulties using OpenGL. Therefore, the preferred option for good Vulkan performance might be Ryujinx. Another crucial aspect is that the game has a native dynamic FPS. This means that if you want to make the most of the performance your PC can offer, you can simply unlock the FPS limit. To do this in Yuzu, press Ctrl+U. In Ryujinx, press the Tab key. With this information in mind, let's proceed with the performance tests on both emulators. It's important to emphasize that we are evaluating performance on the game's first release day, and the emulators have not yet received the necessary fixes and patches for full optimization. This might take a few months to be implemented. As we can observe, throughout most of the gameplay, Ryujinx maintains a higher frame rate. This is likely due to the Vulkan API being more efficient than OpenGL, even with an Nvidia GPU. However, it's noticeable that the Ryujinx emulator faces visible graphical issues. On the other hand, Ryujinx optimizes the usage of GPU and VRAM, utilizing just over 1 GB of VRAM and having a lower CPU load consumption. In turn, Yuzu is capable of rendering all elements correctly, with lower RAM consumption. However, when observing the frame time, we notice some instability, likely due to the use of OpenGL. Additionally, there is evident CPU bottleneck when using Yuzu. If you watched the comparative video between RPCS3 and Xenia running this game, you might have noticed that as you approach the city, the FPS drops significantly. How do Yuzu and Ryujinx perform in this segment? While not experiencing as significant drops as in RPCS3 and Xenia, there is a drop in FPS in both emulators. In Yuzu, the FPS dropped from almost 60 to 29, while Ryujinx managed to maintain around 40 FPS in the same point. Regarding native resolution and considering a roughly 3-minute course, the obtained results were as follows. In Yuzu, the average was 42 FPS, with a minimum of 24 FPS and a maximum of 60 FPS. The low 1% was 21 FPS. As for Ryujinx, the results were slightly better, with an average of 48 FPS, minimum of 18 FPS, and maximum of 65 FPS. However, the low 1% was worse in Ryujinx, reaching 18 FPS. Based on these results, we can conclude that Yuzu presents a lower average FPS, but in terms of stuttering, Ryujinx might have more issues. And for those who plan to play in 4K resolution, the big question is, can we maintain at least 30 FPS? Let's conduct that test now. In Yuzu, we were able to maintain a rate above 30 FPS in areas with low density of people and buildings. On the other hand, with Ryujinx, I experienced both a surprise and disappointment simultaneously. When using the 4K resolution scale, the emulator encountered issues with tree foliage and grass. However, the performance was excellent, reaching a maximum FPS of 65. The results in 4K resolution were as follows. In Yuzu, we achieved an average of 30 FPS, with a minimum of 20 and a maximum of 39 FPS. The low 1% was worse in Yuzu, hitting 17 FPS. In Ryujinx, we attained an average of 53 FPS, with a minimum of 26 FPS and a maximum of 65 FPS. The low 1% was 26 FPS in Ryujinx. It's worth noting that Ryujinx deactivated most of the game's environment to achieve these results and is running on Vulkan, a lighter API than OpenGL. While I was finalizing the video editing, I noticed that a new PR, pull request, was released for Ryujinx, fixing the issues with broken vegetation. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, it's just a matter of time until the emulators can run the game correctly. I won't compare the entire game again, I'll wait until Yuzu also receives a fix and starts supporting Vulkan. However, I will provide an updated comparison, using the new Ryujinx PR to run the game at an impressive 4320p. The link to the PR will be in the video description. Soon, later today, I will release an update about this pre-release. Folks, we're wrapping up the video for today. As the emulators receive improvements, I will bring more updates to you. If this is your first time on the channel, don't forget to subscribe. I wish everyone a great weekend, and see you in the next video.